I'm the founder of Ethnic Diagnostic Alliance Pakistan. This organization I started in Pakistan in 2012. And it was really a first organization, very first organization, which I have started in 2012 in Pakistan. And in this regard, they persecuted me in blasphemy law. So I had to leave Pakistan. I had to flee from Pakistan. And I paid a lot. Yes, I must say I have suffered a lot in the name of Islam, especially. I had to leave my family, I lost my friends, even I lost my work, and lost my daughter as well. She is now 9 years old. But this is what is Islam, yes. So let me come to the point. There is currently an issue going on against Pakistani free thinkers, atheists, and ex-Muslim. We have our own currently one non-able person arrested by the Pakistani authorities on charges of blasphemy. He is known as Ayaz Nizam, Vice President of our organization, Atheist and Agnostic Alliance Pakistan. He had lived decades as a Muslim scholar and has seen Islam really closely. Nobody in the Pakistani ex-Muslim circle knows Islamic theology better than him. After leaving religion behind the wall himself to expose its reality to the masses, he couldn't publish his criticism of religion publicly, as no publisher would risk publishing such a discourse. The rise of the internet and its availability to the common man gave like-minded free thinkers to connect through social media. So this is what I asked Nizam. But now he has been arrested on 22nd March by FIA Pakistan. FIA is the authority from Pakistan. So they have been arrested him over posting blasphemous content on Facebook. But I want to say that support Pakistani atheists and free thinkers people as they are living in danger. Many of them are running for their lives. Their families' lives are also on stake. There is no one to stand with them because this is really dangerous to speak against religion in Pakistan. Because in Pakistan, 98% population is Muslim. There is only one way. When you come to Islam, there is no other way. You cannot leave Islam. You cannot announce your religion again. But yes, if you are Muslim, then you are really fine with this community and society in Pakistan. But if you are Christian and someone else, then you are not spared. Really, you will be in trouble. So what I want to say that please stand up with us and raise this voice, because if we will put pressure on the Pakistani government to abolish or end blasphemy law, then this issue will be solved. Otherwise, we have no choice. We have to speak up. We have to stand up for our own rights. Thank you so much.
Mohammed Nouri, Iran. Adirham.
Thank you very much. I know you're all very tired, so I won't talk for very long. I do want to say that, you know, when we talk about the right to choose, very often it's only about the right of the religious to choose. It's never about the right to reject religion, to choose atheism. And partly it's because religion is so privileged in the world today. A large part of it has to do with the fact that religion is intertwined with the state. And blasphemy laws, apostasy laws, are very useful in silencing dissent and crushing any sort of opposition or criticism. From my perspective, I think there are many, many atheists in the so-called Muslim world. It is a tsunami of atheism. There is an ex-Muslim atheist in every Muslim family, and I think that's why they are so afraid. The Pakistani government, instead of arresting Islamists that are murdering thousands upon thousands of people via terrorism on the streets and marketplaces and schools and even mosques of Pakistan, they attack and arrest and punished with even the death penalty, free thinkers and blasphemers. They equate atheism with terrorism because they fear the immense amount of free thought that is taking place in the Middle East, in North Africa, in South Asia. There is truly a tsunami, and something that I think, if we look at what the printing press did to Christianity, social media is doing that today to Islam. And that's why they fear free thinkers, they want to silence them. Unfortunately, we live in a world that even outside of the 14 countries that punish apostasy and atheism with the death penalty, even here in countries in Europe, we find that there is a sort of normalization of blasphemy and apostasy laws. So they are de facto blasphemy and apostasy laws, where they use concepts such as Islamophobia or safe spaces in order to silence criticism. But the reality is that we have no choice but to speak and to criticize, especially because we have people like Ayaz Nizami, because we have people like Elias Sahar Eliassi, because we have people like Sina Dehman in Iran and Pakistan, Raif Badawi in Saudi Arabia. We have an added responsibility to speak and to defend them and to stand with them. When people are being killed for apostasy and blasphemy, we have no choice but to celebrate blasphemy, to celebrate apostasy, and to mock religion, to mock it so much that it is no longer something that anyone fears, that anyone can die for. So I encourage you to continue fighting for our blasphemers and apostates. They are our dearest and our greatest across the world. And any defense of the right to choose, any defense of any freedom and rights has to be first and foremost the freedom of the dissenters. And that is our apostates and blasphemers today. Thank you very much.